Okay.
And guys, if you like a fat girl, JJD just go to your fat. If you like a skinny girl, JJD.
But then what is that skinny girl?
What is skinny become fat?
Then
you must look for those girls that you like, their life will never adjust.
Hi guys, welcome back to my channel. It's Somi here again. Thank you so much for clicking. And if you're not yet a subscriber, please subscribe to my channel, okay? Alright, so I'm here with my girls today, as you can see. So everybody, oh yeah, from Ziola, introduce yourself.
Ziola.
Sesame.
She got the baby bread concord.
Wow.
Okay.
Okay.
So yeah. We are just gonna be talking about all things relationship, our experiences and our expectations in general in relationships, and from guys and all that. So I'm sure if you have experiences, man. Obviously. So yeah, let's get started. The first question is, what's the best way a guy can approach a lady? And like, how have you been approached in the past? And did you like it? Did you not like it?
He's sitting in your car, you're telling me,
yes,
But the best is me sitting out with my friends and you're over somewhere and you're telling us you're paying for the bill.
You want money? I'm asking the question about that coming
up. You need the money to introduce yourself because money is romance.
Yeah, definitely. I definitely don't like a guy that thinks he can get you with his money. Yeah. They think, okay, once I spend on that, I should.
Everybody's not that table, which means you know.
You don't see that. Show me.
Let you have the money. Show me. Try me and see if your money can get you.
Final verdict, what's the best way a guy can approach you?
Just walk up to me and speak to your business, man. What do you want?
I think sometimes a guy can just ask for the social media handle because sometimes it can be hard to give the number.
Guy by appearance, like first sight. There are many people
that not necessarily have appearance.
So like just how even the introduction the person gives on the first meeting. Mm-hmm. I know it's very important, but if you judge people based on that, I know a lot of people that have helped me and are still helping me. But in the first time, like when I met them and their introduction, it's not someone I feel I can be talking to all
people. I get that. But also,
it's just someone's vibe. Like,
it's just
aura. You can just tell.
The
like,
thing is, they tell you, like,
the way I've set up myself is whether today we talk, tomorrow we don't talk. If I never met you, nothing will happen to my life, whether you're in it or not. So I'm less interested. From there, I can start counseling you and just give you my number. And
so basically, some people are fine.
How good.
The final bet is just walk up to Harvey.
No,
walk up, sound nice,
and then you're nice. Okay.
Nice. Don't try too hard. Try too hard. You want to be funny.
Yeah, don't try too hard.
Don't try too hard. Just be cool.
It's good to be.
You want to grab Jules.
I said sometimes you don't have to try so hard.
Yeah.
And don't keep asking for the number. Like if she says no, just leave her or ask for a social media.
Girls can be just keep trying.
But for them,
my girl,
my
girl,
my
girl,
my
girl, my girl, my girl, my girl, my girl, my girl, my girl, my girl, my
girl, my
girl, my girl, my girl,
Exactly.
Or somebody wants to kind of stress again. If I say no, it means yes.
Absolutely.
Okay, all right. So the next question is, what are your deal breakers in a relationship?
Man, I keep thinking about that thing.
Okay,
well, if violent, it's a deal breaker.
No, being gay has to be behind the
door. Someone that doesn't trust you.
Watching if like who is going in and out because I said there's nobody in the house and like your parts just
can you imagine?
That's obsession.
That's scary.
I didn't know. It was like how many people entered your house? I'm like, that they're telling me to know. And I'm like, two, he's like, no, four. I was stuck behind you. There's a guy that I see.
That's the guy that brought water,
and you're telling me I should remember that that kind of person came to my house.
Yeah.
We are over.
Alright, so let's get to the next question. So, what are some of the sexy things guys do that they might not know, but you see, though? What are those sexy things?
I love it.
Yeah.
Smile. So guys smile.
Yeah, essay.
I think singing when driving.
Singing when driving.
Yes.
Send you money or go and do
Don't be excited. capable. It because you're in a relationship.
You're capable.
Yeah,
you don't can
be handle
one
dollar.
Yes.
And then also,
mm-hmm. and then all this whole going out, footing the bills,
exactly.
and all.
It should be balanced.
Yes,
balance.
It should be balanced.
It
can't
be all the time.
Telling you, let's go out. And
me,
the bills.
I just feel
yeah.
right.
But you want to take me out.
You, we both know our financial standing.
Yes.
So it's only right that whoever is making
more money,
should be able to foot the bills
more.
We won't go out and all of
okay,
that.
Okay,
yeah.
I'm
but it's not
that
going to be here always. So
yeah.
sometimes just
always is not nice. What's in the world? Tell me,
I'm
to take you out, and you
especially
know.
Guys that go extra for you.
Yeah, like
yes.
you should know who you're doing it for.
Mm-hmm.
If
yeah.
someone actually
just
cares
everybody.
For you, why not?
Just
like
want
simple.
A guy that's. I don't. I'm not the kind of person that knows to ask when I need, especially financially.
I'm like
so
that.
I always want you
to
always
to
know.
Know.
That.
But how do you
not
money?
If I don't have a job, you don't. How would you say you don't know that I need money?
Even if you have a job,
I'm working and you know that okay, I have a project. Maybe I'm probably paying for my master's or
mm-hmm.
I'm paying back a loan from
mm-hmm.
school or something. You should know that the money I'm earning is going somewhere.
Yeah.
What's left for me, and this is what I still have to do financially.
Yeah.
I don't need to ask you.
If
you have a good job, you're earning well, I don't need to ask you because I don't feel comfortable asking.
True.
So
but
anybody
you have
who
to
can
your communication skills.
Yes, but the communication
no,
skill is not letting
so
you know that
yeah,
okay, my salary is going into maybe a school
okay.
loan or something, or I have a project that I'm about to get a car or something.
To
exactly. You should know that. I feel you should know. So anybody that goes extra mile to know and support
yeah.
when we go out like that. It doesn't
okay. The last question is, would you lose weight for your guy?
No.
If it helps you,
because
you
saw
lose
me
that weight.
When he saw
me.
Well,
I'm not even if
you
gain weight.
I don't have a lot.
I
can
get
you
when you are a certain size.
Is it what you want? Is it
what
weight?
Okay, so there are two now. Yeah, the first one, he met you at that size and then he wants you to lose the weight. The second one is, you were slim and sexy. Now the relationship
relationship
so
weight.
The
yeah.
main question is, if your man is complaining about your weight in relationship, would you lose weight for him
if he saw me like that
before we started dating?
Mm-hmm.
Fat
yes.
and all.
Then he's telling me to lose the weight.
What
once we started dating, he's not gonna work. Because he saw me like that.
Yeah.
We started dating like
mm-hmm.
that.
We
will continue
change.
Like that. Okay.
Even if he didn't see you like that, maybe you added and you like the weight you added and he
mm-hmm.
wants you to lose.
To be honest, yeah.
Yes.
What
would
you want? Some people like me.
It depends on what I want for myself.
Like
I'm not. I'm not pressed about the
weight during this
lockdown.
She was very happy now because she has been trying.
To
gain weight. So all of a sudden, maybe you've
yeah.
gotten what you want.
I feel
she's
updating you what I like, what I'm comfortable with.
Yeah, because
this weight
still has to do with someone's personal.
I don't want to be. You like slim girls. I don't want myself to be slim and you're telling me to lose weight. So by the time I lose weight, you don't even care if I'm happy with my body.
That's it. You're going to be unhappy and it's going to affect our relationship. So
simple.
So basically. So basically, if I was fat before we started dating, I'm going to remove
someone
like
that.
But if I added weight during the relationship and it's like
bad.
Exactly, if the weight is bad, because there's some way that actually very unhealthy.
Yeah, that one. Because even
no,
if you're
feel
you
there should be a conversation for him to tell you that he should be able to ask you, babe, what's up? Do you like the way you are?
Yes,
I'm obligated to.
We're only talking from our perspective right now.
Yeah.
You
yeah.
It's not fair to the guy that. What if he does not like this?
That's what I'm saying.
It's not fair to him that
so
you have to
find a relationship.
So that's
and
why you
should
be able to. What if he does not like it?
No.
You might genuinely
no.
not be okay with it.
No,
and
you
can't
tell
me you
then
don't
you
like what I am
talking
about.
It's not your fault.
No,
you are
not
your
fault.
It's not your
fault.
There is no way.
No, but
I
get some
people. Even if you tell me, I will not fast.
Exactly.
Okay, let's leave you
one. And now someone says it.
It doesn't even matter right now. Okay, so I said that you started dating this guy. He was all maybe probably he was buff. all muscle, everything, you know, and he likes that. That would be even like that. And then he stay adding weight, belly start to fall out. Your body start to
you surely see more like words, it.
I'll be back for you if his breast comes out.
You lie.
Yes, because you always have
a friend.
Yes,
you can look again. You guys should go to
Feel free, we know we're all learning, we all have different experiences. So yeah, Thank you so much for watching. So please subscribe, like, to my channel,
and comment.
Yes, comment. We love you. Thumbs up. We
support our girl.
Thank you. All right. See you in my next vlog, guys. Bye.
Bye.
Hey,
I know what I'm talking about. Hey, it's on no recording, no. Jesus. Hey.